Oh, good morning, wakey wakey. Happy Saturday. Holy shit. Man, I got a good night's rest. Feeling pretty good. Really don't feel that sore from the intense fucking cardio skating yesterday. Holy fuck. So, I'm gonna get off here, get in a hot bath, soak my body, just get all my muscles fucking loosened up and ready for the day. And see what we accomplish. Yeah, let's accomplish the day together. You.
I'm gonna go get in the bath.
Yeah. Bath time for me.
Low levels of IGF-1 is actually as bad as having chronically elevated levels of IGF-1. It's like many things in life. There's a balance here. So I want to continue to dive into the mechanisms about what IGF-1 does, what causes it to increase or decrease, and what are the favorable effects of IGF-1? Because guess what? You hear about IGF-1 and its links with causing cancer and Crohn's disease, but there's also favorable things that actually increase IGF-1, like exercise. IGF-1 has been shown to increase during exercise up to 20-fold. So on the one hand, you have activists saying if you eat red meat, it will cause cancer by way of increasing IGF-1. Now you say, well, okay, if that was true, then wouldn't exercise also cause cancer? Because exercise acutely increases IGF-1. Like everything, there's nuance and there's context that we need to understand and differentiate and tease out. So that's where we're going today. It's a little bit more complex. So I wanted to kind of share this with you because so many comments.
Oh, feeling good. Yeah.
Instagram, anytime.
Let's get this day started. Moist, humid, damp, foggy.
Got more, wakey, wakey. Feeling fresh and relaxed.
I'm not sure what kind of day this is gonna turn out to be, but we'll find out together. Pack some orders and get to the post office. Yeah, drop these pipes off.
Yeah.
Edward from Nevada. Thank you so much, my friend. Got your CWA ready? Brandon from California. Got your Swamp Stain shot glass poker ready to roll.
Yep.
And William from Texas. Got you covered. Everybody, Happy New Year. Thanks again. All right, the weather has delivered some slight pressure to the knees this morning. So gonna get this stretch on early and manage the day.
You.
Good stretch. Oh. Hey, if you were waiting for my corncob pipe to come back in stock at Missouri Meerschaum, corncobpipe.com, back in stock. Yes, they hauled ass. Got my pipes tattooed. Yeah, this is one of my signature things, is this is a tattoo on the pipe. You know, most of the Missouri Meerschaums have a sticker that can come off, and then it's just a pipe. This one's inked for life. So if you're looking for a good corncob pipe in the best shape ever, MissouriMeerschaum.com, Dr. Poker Cob. Enlighten your pipe smoking skills. Cheers to the healers. Homemade bone broth. Mmm. Oh, man. Yep. Hey, William, thank you. Brandon, thank you. And Edward, thank you. All right, thank you, everybody. All right, just got all the orders dropped off. Was going to head home. My mom sent me a text saying, the beef people got a deal on some fucking brisket and New York's and other kinds of meat today. So when you're only eating meat, you go where the deals are. So yeah, I'm going to go and see what I can collect. Oh, beef people. 30 pounds of beef. Got me a lot of beef. I was hoping to get the brisket. My mom said that brisket on sale, whole slabs. I asked the butcher, he goes, man, we sold out at 8 a.m. He goes, I got more on order for tomorrow morning, but you better get here early. So, yeah. Damn. Meal prepping. 1 pound balls. Two a day. All right, Salisbury steaks prepared for the month of January. 1 pound burger patties. Steaks, liver, Salisbury steaks. Oh, yeah. All right, off the drying rack, on the drying rack. Oh, yeah. Okay, gonna let that rest. Got my little beef cracklings over here. Ooh, yummy fucking yummy. Cooked perfect. It's one of those days, Anya. I'm glad we got Mr. Sun yesterday, because he is not showing his face today. Hopefully we see him tomorrow. Yeah, I hope so. Yeah. Ooh, man, it is humid out. Damn. All right, all right. Okay, oh, double cheers to healers. Stay hydrated. Right, yeah, just got done talking to Kyle. We're trying to figure out when we're going to be skating again, and it's just raining here. It's been pouring, so today is done. But tomorrow, we're going to try to meet up in the morning. So I was just telling him, like, man, yesterday, let me tell you about this session that I had. So my 1 hour and 5 minute discipline cardio sesh. So when you go into a battle skateboarding, there's two different kind of battles. This is what me and Kyle were talking about. You can get into it to where it really just sucks the energy out of you. It sucks the life out of you. And you get angry, you get pissed. And the only thing that is doing this to you is the skateboard. And you just want to take it out on the board. And the best way to take it out in that mindset is landing the shit, perfect bolts, riding away to regain your energy back. Well, if I was in that mindset yesterday, an hour and 5 minutes, that kind of mental battle, my board would have been splinters, okay, years ago. I would have just splintered that thing. I would have focused it, thrown it, because it was defeating me, and it was defeating me mentally. And yesterday, when I say discipline battle, I go into this battle knowing I will not let myself ever do that again. Okay, I don't ever want to treat my skateboard like that. You know, the skateboard gives me these feelings that make me thrive. So I respect it, and I respect myself. You know, when you disrespect the board, you disrespect yourself. That's how it is. That's the truth. Suck it up. You know, I did it. You know, that's how I was. So with that same mindset, that mind battle defeats you in skateboarding like that, then everything that you're doing in your outside life of skateboarding
is also doing that. And it's just a sick repetition. And you got to get out of that mindset. And it starts with yourself. Let yourself beat yourself. Everything else is going to beat you. And this I've learned, you know, I've experienced it. And I don't want to re-experience beating myself down mentally and making myself feel the worst of the worst. Nobody else can make me feel as bad as I've made myself feel. So it's just not a healthy way of living. And that's a big problem with today's mental health, is that everybody's letting themselves beat themselves outside of skateboarding, you know? It's just happening. It's with everything. It's just the way today is. It's technology. And I come from a place where I existed before all of that, and I am able to get myself back to that time and those kind of good feelings naturally, disciplined, without all this artificial intelligence and stimulation. And so I like living in a pure, simpler time, and I like being in my mind right now, because that's where I am. Ooh, shots fired, look out. So, yeah. But, you know, I understand that there's some people that have only known the negative mindset, have only dealt with the battle their whole entire lives, never ever got to their purest potential. So, the only thing I can say is it's never too late. I mean, I've started over so many fucking times, and starting over the wrong way. And tomorrow morning, this is what I'm getting to. This is the end of the conversation that me and Kyle were having, is that starting tomorrow morning, Happy New Year 2023, Happy New Year's Eve right now, I'm going to go as strict as possible on this this new way of eating. I'm strictly going to do the Salisbury steak diet, pretty much. You know, I don't have a lot of money to spend all at once to you know, feed myself ribeyes twice a day, you know. I don't live like that. So when I can, I will. But I'm going to be having 80-20 Angus beef, you know, shredded chuck roast. And I have weighed everything out into 1 pound burger patties, and have everything freezer prepared for the entire month of January. So I'm going to be doing 30 days of red meat only, salt, butter, and water. That's it. That is it. I'm going to be, I was telling Kyle, I said, you know, the only thing that I'm really putting into my body right now, but not as much as I was, but I still have it in me, is the stevia leaf. You know, the element packets, if I have a lemon one or a watermelon one, they have the stevia leaf in it. So I haven't been 100% off of those, for 30 days. So starting tomorrow, I've gotten the unflavored ones that don't have stevia leaf. It's just potassium, magnesium, and sodium. So I was telling Kyle, I was like, man, I have to have those after we skate, because I always empty the tank. Like, I skate until I can't skate no more. And man, chugging one of those, it guarantees that I don't suffer from muscle fatigue, cramps, headaches, any of that shit. Because I've had that before. I've been electrolyte deficient. And I have been an advocate of fucking hydrating for years. You know, I haven't felt that bad in dehydration. So I stay hydrated. And yeah, I got the unflavored ones for the entire month. And then, so after a month of doing this way, and this is what else I was telling Kyle. I was like, man, in like 4 to 5 weeks of me doing this, the way I've been doing it, I'm feeling amazing every week. I'm noticing these smaller changes, and it's all adding up. So imagine how much better I could feel if I just eliminate a few more things, you know, just a couple more things. and reduce it to the bare minimum and get everything that I need. So I'll be eating a half ounce of beef liver every day. I have all that prepared, have everything cut and weighed. I just got to eat a little chunk. And the way I like to eat it is with pot roast. Salt the fuck out of it, make it like a little taco, fucking eat it. And that should make up any mineral vitamin deficiency that I would not be getting from anything else that I'm not going to be eating. Hopefully, you know, we'll find out, because I'm going to do blood work after it shortly. I'll probably do blood work in 6 weeks, but starting tomorrow morning, New Year's Day, beef, butter, water, and salt, you know, electrolytes, that's it for 30 days. And I want to see how much better I can feel in 4 weeks, you know, because I know how much better I felt getting off the carbohydrates, changing to the way that I'm eating now. It's been beneficial for me. So I'm treating this just like how I'm not drinking. You know, I've been 4 years sober from alcohol. And the other thing I was telling Kyle is, like, you know, my entire life, I have an addictive personality. When I get into something and get feeling good on it, I go all in. I don't stop. I give it my all. And that's on anything that I've ever done in my entire life. So drinking, yeah, when it was time to drink, I'm giving it my all. I'm going all day, all night, and I'm not stopping. And that's how I would do it when I drank. So when I rode my motorcycles, you know, it's, I'm going to go out here. Yeah, I'm feeling good. Yeah, this is fine. But it's like my adrenaline glands are built from the skateboard, and the feelings that you get from landing a trick. Well, the only trick on the motorcycle for me is a manual, and my favorite skateboard trick is a manual. So when I get on a motorcycle, all I want to do is fucking wheelie that motherfucker. And that's what I do. So I, with today's drivers and their phones driving them and their iPads driving the car, I don't really trust going out in public doing manuals on my motorcycle anymore. The risk versus the reward just is, it's not even there. It's not even a thought. It's like not even nothing to me. Now take me to a private road, or, you know, I have a few places I can go around here, but getting there is sometimes hectic. So, you know, one day if I have my own private driveway, that's really long, then I'll be fucking doing what I love on motorcycles, and that's manuals. You know, my whole life I've been addicted to anything that I do. You know, I do it, feels great. Let me get the most out of it that I can. And I've bled everything dry that I've ever done and tried, except for skateboarding. No matter how much I try to bleed it and suck it dry, it's always new and fresh for me. It's always there to start all over. And there's nothing else I've ever experienced in my entire existence that can give me that feeling, you know? And that's the reasoning behind all these setups that I have. They're all memorable times that I spent on them a time ago, you know? And when I get back on them, I can really go back to that time when I had these boards and lived in that time. And it's fantastic. You know, I wish everybody could have that experience, but sorry, I grew up in the golden era of skateboarding. I don't care what anybody says, I did, you know. 85 to 95 was the purest time of the greatest skateboarding ever, in my eyes. Like, all evolution of skateboarding really fucking came together and enhanced in that decade. And I lived that decade. And it's, you know, of course I'm biased. I say that because I lived it, and that's my decade. But it is. I mean, I've been living skateboarding since then. and I've followed it and I've seen it, and it's not like it once was, you know? So I have to adapt to the new ways and all this stuff. But I enjoy it. I like keeping up with it, but it definitely motivates me. You know, when I see all the kids today just absolutely fucking destroying the mindset, and that's what it is, the mindset of these kids, it's like, wow, imagine the potential that I had as a kid if I would have seen this then. Because everything that I had seen as a kid, I duplicated. Everything. Any trick that I saw, I duplicated. And imagine seeing today in 1991. Holy fuck. You know, that's how I think about skateboarding today. That's how I live skateboarding today. I'm stuck, you know, in my decade. But when I look at the new skateboarding, it's like, wow, how it is so encouraging. It is so motivating, and it's breathtaking on what you see go down. And when you see that shit live, oh, man, you get to feel it live. There's nothing else like it. I mean, it's this, it's its own ball of energy. And, oh, man, yeah. Charges your soul. That's all I can say. The way I feel right now after, sorry, that took long, but it was an explanation. It needed to be said. So after all that skating yesterday, that, you know, that intense cardio, that discipline, this new diet, like all of it was a contribution to how I feel right now, how energized I am right now about the future. You know, it's insane. I feel incredible. What I'm taking from this, and you know, what the answer is right now, is to just stay in it. Trust the process. Do not rush, because in my past, the better I felt, the more I did, the less that I would use my brain. I was just, you know, but that was a sugar ran brain, you know. God damn, I did so much shit on sugar. It's crazy. The hardest drug to quit. So this is the whole moral of the story. Tomorrow will be the start of my new life without sugar, any kind of sugar, no sweetener. I'm able to admit now and see all the faults and truths that just weren't presented to me at the time. My mind is so clear right now, and I see everything, I guess, the way that I need to see it. It's, yeah, the only thing that could be holding me down this whole time may give me the greatest relief by giving it up. So I want to see what I feel like in 4 weeks from now, in 6 weeks from then. You know, if I don't feel any difference, of course your mindset is to, well, then you go back to, you can get the fake sugar, and, you know, get the fruit in, get your veggies in, you know, start throwing it all back in, start shitting more, start wiping your ass more, start farting more. Like, I don't even fart anymore. It's crazy. Like, maybe once a day. Bloop. Doesn't smell like anything. I'm like, that's a big difference, because I used to just be like a really good farter. You know, that was almost a superpower. My farts were so powerful, and they're being taken away day by day. So, do I miss it? I don't even really notice it now until I'm talking about it. So, no. None of that stuff is, like, I don't know. It's hard to explain. I guess I'll be able to explain more when I can tell you more after doing it longer. That's the only explanation I can give you. So, yeah. You want to try it? Try it with me. I mean, you know, if you're complaining every fucking day about this and that hurting, supposedly, if you eat like this and just put this in your body, you will eliminate everything that's wrong with you, potentially. You know, maybe not everything, but possibly a lot of it. And I don't have a lot left. I got bare minimum to get rid of, and it's just these fucking knees, you know? You know, my arm, it has metal in it too, so it always hurts. But I'm even thinking now about down the road getting this shit out of my body. You know, I kind of want to get it out. So I need to get my arm cut open. There's a titanium rod that runs down my whole arm here. And then there's another one that runs down here. And I can feel it, you know, and I can feel it more and more every day since removing all these foods from my diet. I'm able to feel more. So with my knee joints, you know, I felt like I lost some ability, but in that ability, I gained another. And that other is this feeling that I always talk about, my intuition. It's just getting fucking sharper and sharper every day now. All these things that I've known are being clarified, and it's nice in a way. It's relieving in a way. So yeah, challenge yourself. You know, don't take it from my words. I'm just here doing it every fucking day, and I'm gonna be doing this fucking Salisbury diet for the next 4 weeks. So I would love it. I would love it for you to join me. I would love it for you to give me your feedback. And but if you're gonna be cheating, like, don't waste my time and give me your feedback. Like, this is for fucking people that are gonna, like, stay true to it. Like, there ain't no fucking half-ass in it. There ain't no fucking game in this. This is for yourself, you know. This is for your own doing. Like, this is the best gift that you could give to yourself, and just detox everything. Do it all at once. You know, it's gonna be hard for the first 2 weeks, but after that, I promise you, it gets better. And then at week 4, you're gonna be like, oh fuck, I'm really just getting started, and you're not gonna want to stop. You're like, you're gonna want to see how much better you can feel. And then from there, it's up to you to manage what you put in your fucking mouth and how your body reacts to it to make you feel. That's it. Before I leave, I can also tell you this. So my mindset before was every day, you know, I'm up at 4:30, got to move this fucking body, go, go, go. Well, I did. I had to do that to burn off all the goddamn carbohydrates and the fucking shit in my body. The way that I'm eating now, I'm almost... I feel like I'm benefiting from not doing that as much. I feel like my body's actually, like, getting a little time to catch up and recover because I'm not having to burn any calories. The way that I'm eating, I don't have to count any calories. None of that shit fucking matters. Like, I just need to eat at least fucking 2 pounds of beef a day. And it sounds like a lot, but it's really not, you know? When you're hungry in the morning, you know, you make a fucking a steak burger. That's a pound of ground beef, cook it to your perfection, and melt fucking butter on it and put salt and eat it piece by piece and enjoy it. You're going to be full all goddamn day, trust me. And then you're going to be hungry at night, you know, in the evening time. And when you get there, guess what? That pound of beef looks pretty fucking good. You're like, shit, maybe I should get a pound and a half, you know? Maybe I should make a little side of half burger in case. So I did that too. I got half pound burgers set aside. After my training days, I noticed I'm hungrier Thursday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. I'm hungrier. Like, that's when I've been adding an extra half a pound of beef in. And I feel like I'm gaining from it. I'm maintaining pretty good. And all my muscles around my rib cage are starting to build. You know, they're building. I wouldn't say that they're doing anything else. They're just building. My abs are starting to build. Like, all this shit. My, you know, my shoulders, my neck muscle, my back. Like, everything is just starting to build. Like, the way it's supposed to build. However my genetics are supposed to be formed in this, you know, in this structure. I feel for the first time in my life, I'm starting to actually get the growth benefits of it. You know, who would have thunk at 46 years old, you're like gonna go through puberty. And yeah, it's pretty cool. So yeah, I get to relive being a teenager and do it all over again. Yeah, do it all over again. Yeah, I feel blessed. I'm gonna try to do it the right way this time. Because the last couple of times, I had to redo it and then redo it. You know, it's like, what if I was eating like this? Would have my appendix ruptured? Would I have had my whole stomach intestines perforated and fucking leaking bile inside my fucking chest cavity? Would that have happened? Was that the inside of myself trying to kill myself? You know, the food? So I look at it different than everybody else because I had to go through that fucking traumatic fucking experience. Now, let me tell you, it's been, 9 months now since I got out of the hospital. And I can fully tell you, I still have a little bit of, you know, a little hard spot here, a little hard spot here, a little hard spot here, because they stabbed me in the fucking stomach 3 goddamn times, fucking ripped my shit open, blew my fucking insides up with gas. So imagine imagine that. Imagine all this shit ripping off your fucking insides, like, pretty fucking gross. And all that gas pain, damn, man, let me tell you, that is some serious shit. Like, I had to deal with that. And if you ever meet somebody that talks about gas pain from a surgery where they blow you up, it took months, honestly months, for that to like feel like it actually was out of me. And it wasn't, it was like in little pockets. I could feel it in my spine. I could feel it in my arms, my shoulders. I could feel it. It was not fun, let me tell you. But to me, you know, every day I just block the pain out. I was telling Kyle yesterday, I was like, yeah, I kicked my toe on my board, kicking the board out yesterday. And, this was a couple years ago, my shit, but I lost a toenail, like I'm bruised, stubbed toe, nothing. Like, I cracked my toenail in half, I clipped it off, and it's fine. You know, it's what it would have done as a teenager. So, yeah. All right, enough gabbing. See you bright and early on that toilet. Sunday fun day. Is the weather going to bless us? Or is the body going to get another day of rest and recovery? Who knows? Find out tomorrow.